Your garden building is exposed to the elements all day every day, so it's really important to protect your building from weather damage. Shingling your roof is easy and can be done within a day. They are a stronger and more durable alternative than felt and can withstand the harshest winter weather. Today we're going to be shingling an apex roof on a standard log cabin, but you can apply the same process to your garden building at home.
If you're shingling an existing building, you'll need to check that your roofing felt is in good condition before you start. Check for any tears or leaks. If you find any damage, you will need to replace your felt before continuing. For a guide on how to do this, check out our other videos on our channel. This installation should be carried out on a dry day, and you'll need a hammer, a ladder, a Stanley knife, and some clamp nails.
Our shingles come in green, red, and charcoal, and they feature an adhesive strip on the back. This sticks the layers together to make them more wind resistant.
It's a good idea to lay out the shingles on the floor first to understand the pattern before you fix them to the roof. It's best to start at one end and work towards the other, and complete one side at a time and leave the apex until last. First of all, you'll need to lay a starter strip. Take your first strip of shingles and point the hexagonal tabs towards the apex. Place the strip flush against the front with the straight side along the edge of the roof. Remove the adhesive backing and fix down with clamp nails. Complete the rest of the row in the same way. When you reach the back, there may be some overhang. Cut this off with a work knife and fix down. For the next row, you will need to reverse the shingles and point the hexagonal tabs towards the edge of the roof. Position the shingles directly on top of the starter strip. Remove the adhesive backing and secure down with nails. The adhesive strip doesn't require any heat treatment. It will affix simply with the warmth of the sun. Take the next strip and place this against the first and fix down. Complete the rest of the row in the same way. Take your next shingle strip and position the hexagonal tabs so they overlap the first row. Cut off any excess at the end of the roof. It's a good idea to keep any of the offcuts in case you can reuse them elsewhere. Make sure to line up the design and cover the nails of the first strip. If positioned correctly, the nails should go through both the layers. Complete the rest of the row in the same way and repeat until you reach the apex. Depending on the size of your roof, your offcuts from one end may well fit perfectly on the other. These pieces can simply be affixed in the same way. Apply the same steps on the other side of the roof. At the ridge, cut the shingle strips into single tabs. You should be able to get at least two tabs from each strip. These are going to form your capping. Start at the front of the roof with the hexagonal tab facing towards the back and fix down on both sides. Take the next shingle and point the hexagonal tab towards the front, placing directly over the first shingle. Take your next tab and slightly overlap the shingle in front and secure down. Repeat this process until you reach the back.
You can now refasten your fascias and finials onto your garden building to complete the install. But for more video tutorials, subscribe to our YouTube channel, or for advice, visit waltons.co.uk.